Welcome, folks, to tonight's game. This one promises to be a good one between the USC Trojans and the UCLA Bruins. And, of course, we look here at our star watch. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
We have two excellent players matched at the point guard position. It's going to be interesting to watch how they each try to get their team involved throughout the game.
This is almost as good as it gets when it comes to great rivalries in college basketball.
I tell you, Brad, it's going to be something special here today. We're in for a real treat. We have two rivals who can't wait to get things going and put another W in the win column.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. Well, Dick, that didn't take very long.
I tell you, they're quick out of the gate, baby.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Number three picks up the foul. First team foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
And here's a look at the first-year player.
Hey, Brad, a first-year player starting his college career. Really exciting times in front of this young man. He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Oh, this man's in trouble. Now, that young guy just can't continue to pick up fouls. They need him in the game. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
They work the perimeter. In the lane, scorches the net with a J. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Looks at the three, can't cut, and it's blocked. The shooting guard takes the feed. Jumper, and come up short. On the dribble, gives it up. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. He tries to knock down the three. The missed shot. Stewart receives the pass. And up. Nails the jumper. Number four receives the ball. Off the mark. Stewart handles the pass. Obvious foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Another great sophomore right here, Dick.
Well, Brad, he's still mature. If you're on the cusp, but it's about improvement day by day, year after year.
First shot is good. Full free throws go. They've got him trapped. They might try and surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dick.
That might not be a bad idea.
On the outside. Tries for two. He hits it. Now looking for the pick.
Hey, it's important that the dribbler really turns that corner hard when he's using that ball screen.
Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nesla, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Number 11 to the line. It's the first. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
And he doesn't miss that opportunity either. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
He pulls up with a jumper. Missed it. Last time I checked, Dick, it was about wins and losses. And there's a look at how the teams have been doing so far in both categories. The shooting guard gets the pass. He puts up the J, knocks it down. This is the type of guy that can throw the whole kitchen sink at you if you're not careful.
I tell you, Brad, he can beat you face up, or he can beat you with his back to the basket. He can step a few feet out, and he's been able to convert. He's a tough, tough matchup.
Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. And the jam. Now that's what I call showtime.
You better believe it, baby.
They look to get it to the inside for the bucket. He makes the shot. Inside, puts up the J, and score it. Down inside.
And the fans love it. Chuck with George said, hey, that's my guy, he's yelling.
Outside. Now the turnaround jumper. Jumper won't go. He's going nowhere. Ball stolen. It's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Gotta eliminate those turnovers.
Top of the circle. Doesn't go. Ali handles the pass. He shoots the jumper. Busts the jumper.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively.
Stewart receives the pass. Gave it up. From the corner. Nope. Grabs it.
They need to get out and run their lanes now.
Fed the low block. Takes his jumper. Missed the jumper. They'll work it around the arc. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
That's a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk, lift their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball, ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
Trying to pack it inside. Puts it on the floor and up and under. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
He puts up the three ball.
Jumping didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. Inside. He takes the shot from the baseline. And he missed. There's a slam. He attempts the jump shot. Scorches the net with a J. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. He tries the jumper. Can't connect. The point guard with the ball.
Look at that spacing.
Takes the jumper. Gets the J to fall. On the dribble, gives it up.
Nice hops.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Number 25 is whistled for the foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket. You know, seniors are a dying breed in college basketball these days. If you're a coach that's lucky enough to have a couple, it can definitely help you sleep at night knowing there are guys on your team who know what you want and know what it takes to be successful.
The Bruins have been great in this have really taking it to their rivals.
It's great anytime you can open up an early lead, but the most important time to be ahead is at the end of the game. There's still lots of basketball for these two rivals and lots of time for both teams to make runs.
Gave it up. He pulls the trigger, sinks the shot.
Up and inside.
He shoots from the corner. Can't get the shot to drop. Now they work it around the perimeter. And we're at the 8-minute mark. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
For two. On the dribble, gives it up.
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy, too much mustard there.
Working it around the perimeter. He goes up with it. They get it to go. Gave it up. About 7 minutes remaining. Had a momentary look from three-point land. The turn of fadeaway jumper. Off the mark. The shooting guard gets the pass. Goes up for two. He's money with the shot. We'll be right back. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. From the corner, he misses the fadeaway. Number 11 receives the ball. Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the right side with a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Off the mark. Balanced teams, Dick. What are some of the things that they'll try to accomplish when they step out on the court?
Definitely, Brad. They prefer a more balanced style, picking and choosing when to force the tempo and when to settle down in the half court.
They work it around the perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper. Nope. Number 13 gets the pass. He tries the three.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Missed the jumper. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. Tries for two, and we'll get a change of possession. These guys have really been able to step it up so far, and they're putting together a very good team effort.
It really takes the pressure off of your go-to guys when the supporting cast is able to make plays, rebound, and be strong on defense. As a coach, when your team is playing together like this, you have to be smiling on the sideline.
Looking for a good shot. He goes for three. Nails a sweet jumper. From the corner, he can't miss.
Hey, this young man's feeling it, Brad.
The perimeter. About 4 minutes remaining. Looking for a good shot. Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
Let's it fly. The Bruins have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Brady's on fire.
Moving it around the perimeter. From the corner, the missed shot. On the left side. For the bucket. That's good. About 3 minutes remaining on the game clock. Trying to feed the low block for two. Drains it.
I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
Perfectly designed, perfectly executed, easy basket.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. The Trojans are considered pretty balanced, I think, when talking about their style of play. Wouldn't you say, Dick?
I think when you have balance, inside, outside, scoring, tempo control, where you control the pace of the game, and that's what they try to do with their balance. They'll go fast, they'll go slow. They try to dictate tempo.
Puts up the J.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. Bust the jumper. They work it around the perimeter. He shoots the jumper. Nails the jumper. Up for two. You betcha. We're at the 1 minute mark. They work the perimeter. And the slam. On the outside, three. Ali is really turning some heads right now. He's on fire.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Stewart handles the feed with the J. Scorches the net with a J. Side, trying to feed inside, puts it on the floor and up and under. At the half, the Trojans lead by 14. USC did a heck of a job shooting that ball in the first half.
I mean, no doubt about it. These boys have given too much time to shoot, if you ask me. They basically had time to wait and get a good shot. The defense was non-existent, Mr. Nestler.
Dick, you got to love these rivalry games, and that bad blood is going to continue in the second half.
Well, I'll tell you, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion. I'll tell you, both clubs playing with a lot of passion, Brad.
Can't connect. The point guard with the ball. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. He attempts the jump shot, off the mark. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Top of the key. Nope. He's too important to this team to be picking up fouls like that. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
He'll get the free ones. Misses the free one. Second one, no good.
Check that basketball with that good defensive rebound. Then I've got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
On the outside. Attempts the three. Missed it. Buries it home.
Dipsy dude, Dunkaroo, are you kidding me?
He takes the three. They got it. On the baseline. Goes up with a shot. Scores it. Tries for two. Goes. They go into the low block. Jumper. Jumper won't go. With a jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
They'll work it around the arc. He tries the jumper. The missed shot. Pushes it up. Puts up the J. Nails a sweet jumper. And the intensity is definitely starting to grow with this crowd right now, Dick.
Hey, this is definitely one of the toughest places to play and get a win. The team, the crowd, the noise, this place has all the ingredients to make the visiting team's day a long one.
He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot. And come up short. The small forward handles the pass.
Look at that spacing.
He's too important to this team to be picking up fouls like that. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
So he'll get an opportunity to change the scoreboard again from the free throw line.
Well, he created a foul opportunity.
He hammers it home. Strong with a ball and strong with a finish.
I tell you, he was fearless right there. Did a great job taking it to the rack. It's a great concentration to finish strong.
For the bucket, knocks it down. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
For two, off the glass and no good.
To get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
An errant pass. pass out of bounds for the turnover.
Well, you credit that to two factors. One, great team defense, but number two, lack of communication offensively, not in rhythm and sync.
Dribble, gives it up, goes up for two. It sticks. Now trying to feed the low block. The shot from the baseline. Can't connect. The small forward takes the pass. Might be a ball screen here, Dick.
Well, you got to use that screen. Hey, how the dribbler uses the screen is important in a pick-and-roll situation.
He goes up with it.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. He looks for three. Off the mark. Can't put it down. There was no doubt about that one. The elbow, they feed down to the low block. Takes a medium range jumper, missed the jumper. The point guard gets the pass.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the 3-point line. Up and inside.
Goes up with it. Knocked it down. He can't let this guy have the uncontested shot.
He just got to dig in and play some D.
Number four takes the feed. He'll take the shot. Perfectly executed. Dumps it in. Goes up. Missed it. Gave it up. Had to go up high with a shot.
Excellent jump shot right there.
They look to get it to the inside. Tries for two. Off the mark with that shot. Number four takes the feed. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Pandemonium has taken over Pauley Pavilion. Look out. Puts up the jumper. Busts the jumper. Inside. He pulls up with a jumper. Scorches the net with a J. Who'll be able to use their tempo and come out with a win here, Dick?
Well, it all comes down to execution. If you can put points on the board playing your style, your opponent will have to make adjustments that may affect their tempo and what they will do well.
Buries it. Around 8 minutes remaining. On the dribble, gives it up. He bombs from outside. He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots kill chemistry, Brad.
For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. Down inside. Jumper They get it to go. About 7 minutes remaining. Bed the low block. Goes up with a shot. Bust the J. He shoots from the deep corner and scoring. This game is definitely about rivalry. Let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews. Hey, Aaron, it looked like we were going to have blowout city, as Dick would say, in that first half, but now we got a ball game here in the second half.
Guys, during halftime, emotions were high from both the coaches and the teams. They all said they expect a battle on the hardwood in the second half, and that's what they're getting.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Every time these rivals meet, another chapter is written. Wouldn't you say, Dick?
No kidding. And the best part is that the book rarely ends. The detestable rage grows bigger and the stakes get higher. Great for spectators and folks like you and me.
Doesn't go. The point guard takes the pass. 6 minutes left on the game clock. With the J.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Working it around the perimeter. He puts up the J. The missed shot. Number 11 takes the feed. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Dick, I've heard you talk about this a million times before. How about the number of baskets that have been scored in the paint here?
Well, if you get the ball inside this many times, your team is going to be out in front. I like how determined they've been in getting the ball in the paint.
Top of the circle, they're working around the perimeter. Gave it up. He pulls up with a jumper. Bust the J. With the J. They got it. Well, Mr. Vitale, it looks like we're in for a great finish here.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws, rebounding. I wonder what it'll come down to in this game.
The Bruins can't afford to have him pick up too many more fouls. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, by the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's a matter of bringing it every day.
He goes to the free throw line. Sinks it. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Hey, they got him in some trouble, Brad.
And a momentary look from three-point land for two. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. They move it into the front court. Off the glass. They work it around the perimeter. He throws it up from downtown. The Bruins got some good ball reversal there.
Hey, when it comes to passing, more is always better. Anything to get the defense moving in and out of a defensive stance.
Dumps it in. Number three is called for the foul. Second personal foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
He'll shoot two. He hits the first. That line is really being good. to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Second one, good. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Jumper. He gets it to fall. The shooting guard with the ball. He goes up with it. Scores it. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. To 15 to 17 feet apart.
With the jumper. Scorches the net with a J. About 3 minutes remaining. The small forward receives the pass. Trying to pack it inside. Puts it on the floor and up and under. He misses the jumper. Lays it up. On the low block.
Gotta take some pride on the defensive end.
He shoots. In and out. Number five handles the pass. Looking for a good shot. Takes the three-pointer. He misses the J. The point guard handles the feed. Dumps it in. He shoots from the deep corner. Misses the tray. Was that beautiful or what? Foot with a rejection. The shooting guard gets the ball. Scorches the net with a J. What a reaction.
What a reaction, Brad. The fans are loving it.
One minute left to go. Here's a double team. Had to go up high with a shot. Nails the jumper. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Puts up the J. He misses the J. Two-man action. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? The offense sets up from the sideline. And the clock stopped with a foul. Sideline inbounds. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. The clock stopped with a foul. They're set to inbounds from the baseline. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Number 13 goes to the line for the first time. He makes the front end of the 1-1. Nothing but rim.
Gotta get one on this possession, baby.
And we've got a pause in the action. More NCAA basketball coverage coming up right after this. I'm out on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, this is probably a wise timeout here. As you guys know, it gives the coaching staff a chance to discuss strategy, discuss plays, and point out cues which will help the players make decisions. Let's see what unfolds here, guys.
What would you be saying to your team, Dick, right now if you were on the sideline?
I've been telling them to play tough on a defensive end. Right now, getting stops are a key. Just trading baskets isn't going to help. You need to keep your opponent from putting up points. I'd also make sure everyone knew what we were doing on offense. You need to have all five guys working together if you want to execute down the stretch.
There might be a change in the game plan right now, Dick.
Could be. Got to be ready for anything if you're the opposition.
Three-pointer. Can't get the shot to drop. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Number 0 goes to the line for the 1-1. Makes it! Hits that one! We're ready to get things back going again after the timeout. On the dribble, gives it up. He drains it. It's a 4-point game.
This one could go either way. Don't give up your seat.
If you want to know how aggressive a team is, you check to see how many times they go to the free throw line. That's a great indicator.
Gets his second. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you got to think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
Looking for a good shot. He attempts the three and come up short. And now let's take a look at our players of the game.
A real nice performance by both young guys. Some special players.